Hello, and welcome to episode 12 of Listen Update, a weekly show produced by the students in Television Production 3. I'm Joseph Escolas, and up first, we have our top stories. On June 2nd, the MHS class of 2018 left the building and left their mark as they left the school they've come to love. Jake Stiner made a news story of this historic event.
At MHS, the class of 2018 is finishing their final chapter here at MHS. Today's graduation day, and there's high excitement and high nerves for everyone who is graduating today.
As every graduate made their way to the front of the podium to receive their diplomas, the class of 2018 said their final goodbye to Middleborough High School.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Middleborough High School graduating class of 2018. Don't go home.
I was fortunate enough to be able to interview some of the newly graduated students about their four-year journey through Middleborough High School.
I loved my time at Middleborough High School. Everyone always says, oh, I want to go to different schools and stuff like that, but really, Middleborough is home.
Today's probably the most bittersweet day I've ever had, because we've made so many great memories and it's been such an amazing, life-changing experience. And I'm so sad to see it go.
Graduates of the class of 18 ended with some final messages to the soon-to-be seniors of MHS.
Enjoy it while it lasts, because I still remember getting my green Start Strong shirts and saying, oh, this is going to be so long sitting in classes, watching all the other seniors leave, and now I was sitting down about to turn my tassel, and I'm like, wait, now I'm graduating. So it's a journey.
Just always believe. I touched on it a little bit, but anything you set your mind to, you can accomplish, and things may not always be easy, but if you just believe and do things you love with people you love, then you'll be okay.
Congratulations to the class of 2018 and to all those who graduated. We wish you the best of luck in any of your future decisions. From Listen Update, I'm Jake Steiner. Back to you.
The class of 2018 went on their annual senior walk on Friday, June 1st, where they drive throughout the town of Middleborough with their classmates and visit all the schools in the district. Allison Connors, Cami Morano, Jamey Woodlock, Jake Donohue, Katie Benson, Leanne McDonald, Maggie Desrosiers, Noah Miles, Shayne Quersher were all there filming. Let's take a look at what they got.
When the moment comes, you'll say, I swear I lived. Hope that you spend your days, but they all add up.
The MHS Art Department hosted their annual celebration of the arts in the gym on Friday, May 25th. This marked the 18th year of truly inspiring elementary, middle, and high school students. This show is to appreciate and love the hard work of these students. Let's take a look.
Art is everywhere, and in my opinion, at the core of what separates us from the rest of the animal kingdom. Whether in song, dance, two-dimensional, three-dimensional work, or product design, art is the key factor defining our humanity. Having a creative outlet for students is highly important on both the personal and practical levels. Being creative allows one to express their ideas, feelings, and emotions at a very personal level. Having a creative outlet provides an emotional release for many that our high-paced society so seldom allows for.
On Saturday, May 26th, the senior class held their annual car show fundraiser. Here's Isabel Perry giving us an inside look at this unique event.
The senior class went all out for an amazing car show with music and fun. Every car was remarkable, and with each vehicle came a different story to tell.
My name is Bob Dovner. I'm the car guy at Oak Point. I'm president of the Oak Point Classic Car Club and a personal car shopper. And we're glad to be over here today at the scholarship raising money for the Middleborough High School graduates. Beautiful show and a beautiful day. And I've got my 2011 Chevy Camaro SS Synergy Series convertible. It's 2011, it just turned 13,000 miles. We enjoy going to the car shows with it and going down to Plymouth with our dog Hunter to have some fun. It's only one of 99 built exactly like this with the Synergy Series. Window sticker was over $53,000 new. Maximum speed is 156 miles per hour. It's got 400 horsepower. It's got Pirelli 0 21 inch racing tires, 21 inch rear wheels, front and back, 8 inch in the front, 9 inch in the back. It's got a lowering kit, body side panels, front splitter, and it's really a great car to drive. I mean, it's a great cruiser going down by the beach and just having fun with it at the car show. So we're so glad to be here today. I hope everybody has a great holiday weekend.
Hi, I'm Ray Timmons. This is my car. It's a 1936 Ford. I live here in Middleborough. This car was restored by a company in New Hampshire called Restoration Services.
A total of 26 awards were given to the best cars. A 1942 Chevy truck won People's Choice, and a 1969 Chevy Chevelle won Best in Show. This is Isabel Perry with Listen Update.
That's Entertainment 40, May the 40th Be With You, was a big hit. The kids in STW performed the show on May 24th, May 25th, and May 26th. Megan Doherty made a highlight of the show. Let's take a look.
Welcome. spotless sky. Please tell us why
you had to hide away for so long.
Where did we go wrong? Hey there, Mr. Blue, we're so pleased to be with you. Look around, see what you do. Everybody smiles at you. Hey there, Mr. Blue, we're so pleased to be with you. Look around, see what you do.
On June 5th, members of the Middleborough Student Council gathered in the auditorium to commemorate a remarkable year with a StuCo banquet. Here's Chase Holyoke with the story.
On June 5th, members of the Middleborough Student Council gathered in the Wayne M. Karen Memorial Auditorium to celebrate the past year. This event was created to highlight key members of the delegation and what they've been able to accomplish in only a few months. I asked former council president Eric Jacobson who he thought had a phenomenal year.
If I had to pick one person who really stands out, I think it would have to be Chris Cogan. He took a big risk running for CMAS delegate this year, and I really accommodate him for that. And he's always has a smile on his face. He's always ready to go. He's always able to lend a helping hand. And just someone that's really awesome having the delegation with.
With the year coming to a close, it's time for the young members of the council to say goodbye to the seniors. Though it's hard to let go of the veterans, it's time for the rookies to shine. I asked Eric for any advice for any new leaders, and this is what he had to say.
Just do it, guys. That's my only advice. Just go out there, have fun, and just do it. Do what you love. Would it be student council, if it's sports, arts, but I really hope it is part of student council. Just try out for the position, chair an event, go to everything you can, and you want to. It's an awesome time, and you won't regret it.
Sadly, Eric must say goodbye to his presidency. He plans to go to UMass Amherst in the fall for a major in politics and government. With such a great impact on MHS, Eric leaves big shoes to fill for Heidi Cretion, the incoming council president. Heidi spoke with me about her plans for the year.
So my plans for the upcoming year are to make this year the best year for our high school experience, because last year's board did such an amazing job. I hope to keep that momentum moving forward and just build upon it.
With many graduating leaders out of commission, the future of MHS must step up and take charge. Though wonderful and amazing, the experience itself can be quite challenging. Heidi was able to share her feelings about the new crew.
I'm excited to see how well we work together and what we're able to accomplish through collaboration, because a lot of boards in the past have been successful about it, but I feel like this year it's really about connecting with one another, and I'm excited to see what that connection can bring to the school.
Overall, this council has been consistently fantastic in everything they do. It'll be no surprise when these young leaders fill in to do amazing things on behalf of their senior counterparts. No matter what happens, the community will be proud regardless. From Listen Up, I'm Chase Holyoke.
With the school year of 2017 to 2018 coming to a close here at MHS, there is a moment we can take to reflect on how this year went and look forward to the exciting things at the high school for next year. I spoke with Mr. Brannigan and Mr. Dizell to find out their opinions. So what's next, MHS?
We had, in general, a really good school year. It was relatively free of major incidents, and we graduated a phenomenal class of 2018.
I'm really excited and proud of the 21st Century Learning Conference. That, I think, was a really cool activity that we did that I think got really rave reviews from students. The Wellness Week, and really making a commitment to our students and our teachers that we're making a commitment to health and wellness at the high school.
In general, I do want to continue to keep working on our safety initiatives to make Middleborough High School and MPS the safest it can be. But also, I'm looking forward to bringing in a new freshman class this year, next year rather, and preparing them for great success here at the high school.
One of the focuses that we really are going to have next year is working with the ninth graders, and really how do we bring them up to the high school and ensure that by the time they finish their first year of high school, that we can guarantee that they're walking out with a tremendously successful year, because the research shows that if a ninth grader has a great ninth grade year, that the chances of them having graduating on time is significant.
New and pretty exciting is we're going to be welcoming in two brand new SROs next school year. I think it's a great opportunity to thank Sergeant Greg Trask for an amazing 6 years as our SRO, but we're excited to bring on two new SROs to further enhance safety and security in the district.
For students, one of the things that I want to make sure that we do is ensure that we have a really robust college and career planning process, and to really ensure the fact that we're tapping into the goals of every student in the classroom.
I'm looking most forward to bringing in a new freshman class. I know that the eighth graders are chomping at the bit to get out of middle school and come up to the high school, and I'm looking forward to welcoming them to the school next year.
Our school together, taking another huge step in the story of our school, making it even better. The building, the beginning of the building of the new Middleborough High School will start next year. And I just couldn't be more excited to get a year started of some new and exciting events and activities for students, and to make sure that we can get all of our students back here in their second home.
MHS baseball season has come to a close as they lost to Ashland 3-2 on Friday, June 8th. They finished their season with a final record of 11-11. Congratulations to Harrison LaPierre, Dan Bucunt, Brandon Hogan, Colin O'Brien, Sean McCarthy, and Evan Gavush, who are all named League All-Stars. Congratulations to the boys and girls tennis teams for qualifying for the MIAA state tournaments. The girls team, led by singles players Olivia Shaw, Sarah Stearns, finished the regular season with a 12-7 record, but lost to Medfield in the preliminary round. Congratulations to first doubles teams Bridget Lynch and Tori Warner for being named South Shore League All-Stars. The boys' team finished with the regular season with a 10-10 record to qualify for the tournament on the last day of the regular season. The boys' team, led by senior co-captains Ryan Baker, Eric Jacobson, won their first preliminary round 4-1 against Bishop Conley before losing it in the first round against the number one seed against the Maimonides 4-1. Congratulations to first singles players Ryan Baker and third single player Declan Hastings for being named South Shore League All-Stars. Ryan finished the season with 18 wins and 3 losses, undefeated in the South Shore League, and was named South Shore League Player of the Year. Boys lacrosse had a big win over Greater New Bedford Regional Vocational Technical High School 4-2, and Matt McNaughton was there to create a highlight of the game. Let's go check it out.
I am floating, floating out to sea. Yeah, contrary too popularly, I ain't invincible, not even close. I'm just a little girl, a failure to most. I'm a flower, a flower left for day. Oh, this bitter world, she's out for my
Up next is weather, but first, let's look at some commercials produced by TV1 students Allison Connors, Cami Morano, Jamey Woodlock, Jake Donohue, Katie Benson, Leanne McDonald, Maggie Desrosiers, Noah Miles, and Shayne Quersher.
Little Big Pack, call 1-800-LITTLE-BIG or go to littlebigpack.com.
Have you ever needed alone time? Well, now you can find that alone time with the Unseeable Cloak. All you have to do is just throw it over your body and poof, you're gone. As you can see, this cloak makes you invisible to anything. Once you're done with your alone time, all you have to do is just take off the cloak. Once you're done with the cloak, snap your fingers so you're able to see it again and not gonna lose it. All you have to do to get your $199.99 cloak is call 1-800-INVISIBLE to get it, and it comes with free shipping and handling.
Blast. Have you ever wanted to take to the skies like your favorite Fortnite character has in Fortnite Battle Royale?
Well, now you can. For just 27,000 V-Bucks, $500, you can buy one today at www.tencent.com/epicgame/fortnite/jetpack/buy.
And before you go, buy one, get the next one for 50% off.
Yes, that's 50% off the second jetpack. Must be bought by a parent or guardian over the age of 18.
We're not liable for anything that may happen to you or someone using the Fortnite jetpack. Once you buy, there is no support from us, and there is a warning danger sign, so there can be no lawsuits.
Buy one today.
Have you ever been too tired to get out of bed for school? Use W to send out a clone so you can have more time to sleep or study. To use W, all you have to do is answer a simple series of questions about yourself and your schedule. Your clone will be able to appear for 4 hours without any in-app purchases. Download W today for a reasonable price of $6.99.
Oh, hey, Dylan.
Oh, hi. Oh, girl, your tan lines are so bad. You need this.
Sprung glasses? What's that?
It's this wicked cool spray that's invisible. You spray it once on your eyes and no embarrassing tan lines, and it's doctor approved.
Has this ever happened to you? Regular glasses are overpriced and break too easy. With the Sprung glasses, it's an affordable price and doesn't have the ability to break.
Save the embarrassing moment with the Sprung glasses.
Buy the Sprung glasses with the number 1-800-SPRUNGGLASSES or at the website sprungglasses.com with a price of $14.99.
Have you ever fallen short of your athletic ability? Have you ever been embarrassed by your lack of athleticism? Have you ever let the humiliation of being unathletic get you down? Well, now the complete and utter embarrassment can come to an end with the newest Athletaboots. All you have to do is slip the incredible sneakers on your feet and the invisible magic will flow up into your bloodstream, allowing you to instantly perform like an athletic beast. Athletaboots are a great way to boost your athleticism without poisoning your body with toxic chemicals. The easy, controllable, and comfortable sneakers are simply activated as soon as your feet are cozy in the shoe.
Thanks, Athletaboots!
Buy Athletaboots now for only $49.99. Call 1-800-ATHLETABOOTS or visit our website, www.athletaboots, to order a pair now.
Oh, these are so good. Like, I don't ever want to finish these.
Wait, have you not heard of Forever Food Spray?
Whoa, what is that?
It's a magic food spray that you spray on your food to make it last forever.
Oh my God, that's so cool. Can I try? Now I can share with everyone.
Buy Forever Food Spray for only $24.99. Order now by calling 1-800-567-FOOD or go to foodfavors.com.
Birken-socks are a special sock that allows you to wear your favorite shoe and have warm feet without the embarrassment of wearing socks with stocks. They change color to match your skin tone and make it appear as though you aren't wearing socks.
Hey guys, look at my new socks.
Oh, it's like they're not even there.
I need to get me a pair of those.
And they're machine washable.
Are you bad at piano? Do you want all the satisfaction with none of the work?
I know I did, and that's why I bought Grand Musician. Now this is what I sound like when I'm on normal mode. Now I'll be switching to pro mode.
Fool your friends and family with all new Grand Musician. Play like a pro in minutes.
Now, here's Aaron Conley with weather.
It looks like Saturday is going to be a sunny one, while Monday has the high of the week at 85 degrees. Expect showers on Tuesday and Thursday, and every other day looks to be partially cloudy. Highs from 74 to 84 and lows of 54 to 65. Back to you, Joe.
The students of MHS have finals on June 21st and June 22nd, and the official end of the school year is on June 26th. Everyone have a wonderful summer. Thanks for watching this week's Listen Update. Make sure to check out MiddleboroughTV.com as well as our Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at MiddleboroughTV for photos and all updates about MHS. I'm Joe Escolas. From all of us in Television Production 3, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next year. Stay safe.